Residential and data center proxies are the most common ones. Like all other proxy servers, they replace your IP address with their own and use it to communicate with the rest of the internet. However, they don't offer the same features and performance. Also, the price difference is often quite big. What sets them apart? How and where to use them? Which one is the right option for you? Hi, my name is Raddy and today we'll answer all these questions and more. Let's start with residential proxies. These are IP addresses borrowed from real internet users and their PCs, laptops, phones and so on. With a residential proxy, you're using these devices to connect to a website, app, game or any other online resource. There are a few key advantages to these proxies. First, and probably the biggest one, is their authenticity. Since a residential proxy is an actual device someone would use to access the internet, there's no way for a website to distinguish it from a regular visitor. In other words, they don't know you're using a proxy. These IPs have the highest trust score, so they're great for all tasks, even non-human ones. We'll get into that a bit later. Residential proxies are also usually a part of large IP pools. Any reputable proxy provider has millions of residential proxy servers you can use, so you'll probably never run into the same IP twice. You are also often able to select the location of your IPs, so they're great for accessing sites and services only available in specific countries. It's also important to note that residential proxies are incredibly easy to manage, especially if you need to switch between different IPs at specific intervals. Provider offers you an URL that connects you to its proxies and selects a random residential IP from the available ones. You can set the interval at which they rotate, which is very useful for non-human tasks we mentioned above, web scraping, sneak copying, and so on. What about data center proxies? Are they better or worse? The short answer would simply be they're different. Instead of real users and their devices, data center proxies come from cloud servers and hosting companies. It's right in their name. So, what are their advantages? The most important one is high speed and uptime. With a residential proxy, you're limited to the speed of a specific user's device and their internet connection. They can also go offline at any time, which can be an issue. Data center proxies solve this problem. They're always online and offer extremely high speeds, often up to 10 gigabits per second. In other words, these connections won't slow you down, and you can rely on them 24/7. This brings us to the second benefit, sharing. Thanks to their high speeds, you can share data center proxies without slowing things down. You don't have to, though, if you prefer to make sure nobody will abuse the IP you're using, just get a data center proxy for yourself. These proxies are also significantly cheaper. Getting a premium data center proxy will set you back just a couple of dollars at most. So, those are the key benefits of both types of proxies. Sounds too good to be true, right? We didn't forget about their downsides. As mentioned above, residential proxies are often slower. Since you're using a device from an actual internet user with a home connection, you never know how fast it is. You also don't know when they'll go offline. On top of that, there's no way to reserve a residential proxy for yourself. You have to share them with others. Finally, the users offering their devices need compensation, so residential proxies are significantly more expensive. As for data center proxies, they come with their own flaws. Since they're not associated with residential users and devices, data center IPs are very easy to detect. That means they're not the best option for websites and online services that don't allow you to use proxies. Also, there's no IP and subnet diversity like with residential proxies. Data center proxy servers come from the same IP address ranges. Certain websites don't hesitate to block the whole subnet if they discover abuse from a single IP. How to avoid these downsides and make the most of your proxies? Use them responsibly and make sure to get them from a reliable provider like IPRoyal. Visit our website to get great residential and data center proxies with great features at great prices. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and learned something you didn't know, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also, make sure to check out our channel, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss our latest videos. See you soon.